Five in 5, 4, 3, 2. Yeah, that look clean right there. That look clean, boy. That look clean. That look clean. Finally. Finally. After all of that. Oh, bro. I was about to say, you know what? Fuck it. But I couldn't be that person. I couldn't be that person. I could not be that person. They will never understand the behind the scenes bullshit. Oh, I ain't get my drink. Oh, damn. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. Oh, God. Ugh. Let me change this. Let me change this. Stream title, yeah. Redacted. Yay. We here now. We here now. Can get started now. And I'm Ace, the greatest to ever live. Ever. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. Forever, ever, ever. I'm sorry, Miss Jackson. Anywho. All right, so what's today's topic? What we gonna get into first? Whole lot of learning. Man. These women? Exactly. Oh my God. Oh shit. Oh, you can't hear L? Let me see. Let me. I might have to turn her up. Oh, she's already way turned up. She's all the way turned up. So is King. I said, so is King. Oh, there we go. Stream volume. Let me get y'all up there. Let me get y'all up there real quick. There we go. That should be better. Proc, can you hear him? They can't hear you. So we're gonna do this. I hear Echo of Ace. What about that? Does that sound better?
Maybe.
Oh.
Wait.
There we go. Wait. There we go. You did something.
All right. There we go.
Hear me.
Nah, because like when I turned off my desktop audio, it turns y'all off. If that makes sense.
Weird. Even though you hear us through your headset?
Yeah, I hear y'all through my headset. Perfectly fine.
Perfect. Perfect.
Okay. But anyway.
It don't matter.
We back
it don't
in
matter.
Here.
Anyway, we back. You're welcome to podcast, Redacted Podcast, episode 3, man. Let's get it started.
Let's go ahead and get it started.
How y'all feeling? I'm feeling good. Did you guys have a good week?
I had a really busy week. It's been a really busy week.
Yeah.
But
it's been busy.
But you know, we back. It's the weekend. It's okay. I'm gonna recharge.
My week was pretty chill. It was a pretty good stream throughout the week. Had fun throughout this week. It's been pretty good ever since I got subbed, to be honest.
No, my ring light is not off. I have like several lights on right now. Like I got my room light, I got a ring light, I have my webcam light on, and I got the window like blinds open. Yeah,
I love that chat is just gonna
We can work on that later. I'm you gonna share your screen and we go take this step by step. Cause goddamn
it, we'll have to figure
it
out.
Goddamn it, we need to get the podcast set up.
Right. Perfectly fine, but yeah.
But thank you for bearing with us on this rocky road. It was a busy week. I mean, me personally, I had a strong week. I had a strong start, really strong start. I feel like I kept some idea of momentum throughout the week. I will say today was very hard to wake up because I knew it was Friday. I had a long night, but I was thankful. And yeah, I mean, I really can't complain. Like, I'm here. I'm about to pull me up some coffee. Yeah. And for anybody tuning in, this gray box is actually because our good sir, Perdiceus, is still out of commission on the line.
Yeah, it's so depressing.
You did put a chat box right there, by the way. Oh, you put the chat box right there, dog.
Yeah, he put it on top of me, which is a vibe.
Well, no, I didn't do anything. This is, yeah, I don't know, because I don't have a chat box, ever.
Oh, that's L. That's L.
Yeah, that's L's chat. What's crazy is it's showing the chat, though. Like,
there's no, that is not my chat box. He's not chatting in my stream.
I'm so confused.
That's facts. He ain't chatting in your screen.
He's
so
not chatting
in
my screen. It's
box.
Like we just moved off. The way he just moved it off.
No, yo, look. My head is everywhere right now. Okay, I need a decompression.
Also, moderator Pride, can you change it from just chatting to podcast, please?
Are we allowed to smoke on stream? Cause
no.
Damn.
Oh wait, no, that's a lie. Cause the old girl with that was doing that that simp
thang
agreement.
With the thang stanging.
Yeah, exactly. She was dabbing and everything.
Yeah. So what we want to start with?
I would like fuck with a dab rig, honestly. I think I'm at the time, not a dab rig per se, but perhaps like a tiny like terp pen that like does like mini dabs. Like dabs, but in moderation.
Like a pen?
Not a pen. Dabs, but in moderation.
You're going to have to teach me because I don't see it.
We're going to have to talk about it.
Yeah.
I don't know. It. I've just been smoking a lot of weed lately.
Ooh.
I've been really into
it. Okay. Copy.
Yeah,
copy.
I'm with it.
Love to see it.
Yep.
A healthy lifestyle is a great lifestyle.
Yeah. I mean, what's going on in y'all's world? I mean, we talked about a busy week. I mean, have y'all been into anything, looking forward to anything, seeing anything?
Well, I mean, what I'm looking forward to is this bonus I'm supposed to be getting next week from my job. And then
come on, coin.
A possible employment. What do you call it? Promotion?
Oh,
come on, promotion.
Okay.
Manifest that.
But you know, I'm just trying to speak it into existence. You know, we're not going to jinx anything, though.
I like it. I like the growth. Blessings headed your way, man. For real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I definitely, for a while there, especially in quarantine, I feel like I was like really quickly to get behind in my work deliverables, and it was easy for me to feel like I was very stagnant in my work progression, like I wasn't doing enough. But I actually just started therapy a couple weeks ago.
We taking steps.
We love mental health. We love taking care of yourself. So I'm very excited to do therapy and keep that going. So that's been a pleasure. But yeah, I mean, I'm just learning to like embrace my work ethic and, you know, take it as what it is and still stay motivated.
Yeah. We love a good work ethic. A good work ethic.
For me, it's the fact that there's just so much going on as far as like work goes. We have so many projects and they're all going on at once. And it's just COVID, working from home. The company I work for is a very old company, so there's a lot of growing pains in that realm.
Yeah,
so just doing that.
I feel that. Much love to that.
Word. Okay, so now we have, you know, just making sure y'all good in the right headspace for today. I would like to bring something that is most pleasing to me in my career. I'm kidding. Actually, Perdiceus, sidebar, I did get my pizza ordered. It's on the way. But anyway, WAP.
Oh, shit.
Here we go, WAP.
Let me tell y'all something. When I saw WAP trending on Twitter, I was like, wait, they brought back the WAP? I was thinking, let me see a WAP. WAP. WAP.
Yeah, okay.
And then I saw it said WAP. I was like, oh. And so I played a video. I'm like, man, it's probably going to be some bougie bootleg ass video. I'm like, oh, okay. Oh.
Do we know what WAP stands for, anybody?
Wet ass redacted.
Love it. Ooh, I don't know if I like my pizza. Never mind.
Boing. That's how I'm feeling. But for anybody who hasn't
heard
it.
Pride. We love it. We love it over here.
Cardi B and Meg Thee Stallion dropped a new song, a new collab, along with a new music video. And apparently, it's supposed to be pretty nasty. Okay, the lyrics are a bit explicit.
Why was Kylie Jenner in there? They did have to
preface that, you know, the video was going to feature the clean version because YouTube wasn't having it.
Can we talk about the video? Can we give a shout out to Quavo? Okay.
Quavo?
You mean Offset?
Wow! Imagine getting the Migos messed up.
They all the same.
What's the third one's name again?
Huncho.
Takeoff?
Huncho.
Oh.
Wow.
Huncho.
Wow.
That's
so disrespectful, man. Don't disrespect him like that.
You really thought you had it.
I did.
He that kid that answers confidently in class and do be wrong the whole time.
The whole time, bro. I'll be like, hey, that's 24. Motherfucker, it's 3.
Exactly.
Oh my gosh. Pride, delete that. Stop.
The answer is a letter.
But I don't know.
What do y'all think about the video? I mean, we saw the video. All right. The video dropped last night.
Before I get to the video, I do like how Meg seems to be back on track with her music career because even though she wasn't really off track or anything, but getting shot or being involved in something like that can be pretty traumatic. So I'm glad she's back on track, making music, making money, shit like that. Hopefully she's still working on what she need to work on to move past that situation. But the video, though, okay, I'm with it.
The video was graphically pleasing. It was graphically pleasing. Sensually pleasing, I guess you could say that. I don't know.
Sensually?
Like arousing.
Arousing.
So you was turned on watching it, bro?
It was
something Meg said that hit me, and I was like, God damn, bro.
Was it the lyrics? Is that what got you?
It was the lyrics, and then when you think about it, it's like, all right. And then I cracked up when Cardi B was like, touch that thang-a-lang in the back of my throat. I was like, yo.
What's it called, the vulva? Uvula?
Uvula.
Uvula. Guys, vulva's on the... That's the other one that's down.
Also, what? I was kind of confused. Why was Kylie Jenner in the video?
Yeah, Kylie. Why was she?
That's the question. That is the motherfucking question.
No hate to Kylie. No hate to Kylie.
Why?
I was really confused on where that came from.
Yeah.
Things that what nobody asked for was Kylie to be in that video.
And then, I don't know, it was just kind of weird for me because she was just kind of, she was involved but not said to be or reported to be involved.
She gave us nothing.
And the whole Megan getting shot thing.
She was involved.
Like, meaning she was in the car. Like, in the car, at the party, shit like that.
Kylie was in the car.
So she pulled a Kardashian.
I think that, I think that's the third person that was in there that they weren't, reported.
No, because they made three people get out the car, and two of them was black girls, and one of them was queer.
Two of them was black girls? Okay, okay.
I saw the arrest video. I know we talked about this in the last week's podcast. But for the context, they were arrested. Tory Lanez shot her. Megan is now better. Megan is like cutting people off, which she should.
Yeah, you should cut. You should definitely cut toxic people.
I don't believe in having
toxic
friends.
You got to cut the toxicity out your life. So
are you friends with me then?
Oh, so he admits it. Cancers are toxic.
Okay, so
okay.
But that clip that.
Yeah, clip that. Yeah, Pride,
okay,
click that.
Okay. Everybody's a critic. Everybody's a critic.
Nah, clip that, bro. That's proof right there.
Y'all be easy. Y'all be easy. Because.
Man. But as far as the video goes, yeah, I liked it. I mean, that shit seemed perfect timing. It is a summer type of song. It's a summer type of vibe. I fuck with it. For the nasty freaks out there.
I'm kind of like over the idea of ho songs.
Yeah, let's talk about that. How do women feel about women talking about extremely highly sexual things or whatever?
Is it actually working this time?
Not Prod making a surprise.
Wow. This man,
I'm
Prod.
I'm trying to get my mic work all day. Hello.
You realize, Prod, you sure you want to do this? Because I do have a picture of you that I drew.
Just put
and
it
we
up,
could
man.
Put
it
that
up.
Motherfucker right there.
We got a incoming airdrop from Prodicius for the
airdrop
Redacted podcast.
Okay, y'all. Let me explain why this podcast is actually a mess. Okay. For starters, Prod doesn't have a PC.
Yeah.
Secondly, Ace doesn't know Streamlabs.
I don't.
Thirdly, I can't fucking be on time. Secondly, finally, King in a whole different time zone than all of us. So this whole podcast, you can expect it to
be. King is the only one that did nothing wrong. That's what I'm
I know, but it's just the fact that you're in a different time zone. I just
That's
had to
okay.
say something. I had to have 4 points. That was
you had
point.
To make it the fourth point, yes.
I had
four.
To have 4 points. That was the fourth point.
We're the four horsemen for a reason. Can't leave one out, okay?
I can't believe this.
Oh, we're the four horsemen. Can I be a plague?
You want to be a plague?
Yeah,
the
four horsemen. You know the four horsemen. There's plague. There was
look. I didn't know the names. I didn't know the names. Jesus, why would you want? You want to be COVID? I've never heard somebody say they want to be COVID.
Hard, so shit.
Let me be a plague. Wait.
God damn.
If you think about it.
What?
Like the power
of a plague.
To take someone at will because you're a plague.
How is that romantic?
I don't know. It's kind of
exactly.
like some like Shakespeare
that's
shit.
That's romantic as fuck. Thank you, Ed.
It's kind of like some Shakespeare shit, like some old ballad that's, shit. Come on.
Exactly. We can't be together, so
tragedy.
Let me spread the plague over the whole land, bro. Like
tragedy,
yeah, bro.
Love. Like,
exactly.
Isn't that not what we're here
Shakespeare,
for?
Shakespeare. Fucking Romeo and Juliet, bro. What
yes.
you mean?
So,
come on, romantic toxicity.
The true toxic members of Pine just got revealed. Clip all of that.
Yeah, that's
thanks for the proof.
Hey,
I
did not admit shit. King the one that said he's
hey,
toxic.
Hey, I didn't know who you're dealing with here.
Yeah, I didn't know, bro. That's no, no. I ain't never heard somebody say they want to be a plague.
What's the
pestilence mean?
Look it up. Dictionary.com.
Yeah. Mind your goddamn business.com.
Anyway, okay.
It's an epidemic disease, King. Okay.
So, COVID is cancer.
Pestilence.
Wait, are you sipping on coffee? Tea?
Yeah, it's like coffee she's on.
Oh.
Excuse me?
She says she wants to stream after this.
This podcast is sponsored by Grinding Coffee Company. Use code Himalayas for
13%
off.
Look at her sponsor.
Look at that. I like how you slid that in. I like how you slid that in there. Didn't tell nobody about the coffee vibe or whatever.
But on the real, I need to be up. So if y'all trying to see the effects of what this coffee has on a person.
Yeah, I'm trying to see.
Sell it to me. Before you consume caffeine.
Sell it to me.
You don't want to see that.
Anywho, so apparently, Mulan is coming to Disney Plus.
Wait, whoa. Hey, stop. Let the moderator
jump. We can jump. I mean, it's fine. I did want to point out, before we move on to Mulan, Dr. Disrespect streamed on YouTube today.
This man skipped the whole goddamn Google Doc.
How? We going to rotate over to... Wait.
What El said, because that was one of our beginning topics. So, El?
Yeah. So, Dr. Disrespect did he ever say what happened? Or did Twitch ever say what happened?
He doesn't know still.
He doesn't know?
He's very ambiguous. No, that's the thing. I bet he does know. I bet there's a lot of legal documents that have been signed no one can speak.
Oh. Think about it like this, and the main reason I'm kind of agreeing with the man is Twitch has had a record, and I mean a record, of banning people and not saying shit. That's part of their policy. They don't say why they ban people.
That's kind of fucked up.
How can you learn from your mistakes if you don't know what your mistake
is? Yeah, that's why Twitch has been under fire for like years, because they'll ban people and they'll be like, why'd you ban me? And then they'll unban them and they still won't tell them why to ban them. They're like, what the? So
that's not cool, bro.
I'm on his side.
So what's the point then? What's the point of banning them then?
They're not gonna tell them.
Hey, you know what? Now that you said that, everybody saw the Dr. Disrespect video. What's the point of going on? What's the point?
Is he permanently on YouTube? Like, he signed a YouTube vid? Sure. Or did he sign like a... Did he sign a deal, is what I'm asking.
Oh, no deal.
Okay.
No deal. But it didn't matter. Boy made like, what, 200K probably today?
So...
Yeah, 500K viewers?
But
$100 donos and like subs every 2 seconds.
My only thing about this Dr. Disrespect thing is like, it was in the midst of like Mixer getting exposed and then shut down, and then like a whole bunch of like racism was exposed and sexual harassment was exposed on Twitch and stuff like that. And then
in that era.
Yeah, like in that time when the whole
energy around. Yeah, the energy was very chaotic when all this was happening.
I think that's what made it so important, or people made it so important to know why Dr. Disrespect got banned from Twitch. I think that's kind of like what made it one of the key things.
Honestly, the best thing I could say about that is, man, that sucks a bit. The guy got banned, but I talked about this earlier. Him being on YouTube make YouTube more important of a streaming platform. We already know.
It did, because now people are actually going to be on the platform.
Yeah, competition between two streaming platforms can be lucrative for everyone. So,
if you count, I know he's not as big as Dr. Disrespect, but he's up there. Gathalion is on FB Gaming.
Oh, yeah, but he went to Facebook.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's on FB Gaming, so it's kind of like he's helping the whole.
Also, Shroud and Ninja. We don't know about them yet.
True.
But Ninja streamed on all of them?
He streamed on everything but Facebook so far.
What's the point of streaming on multiple platforms? Like, I mean,
he was testing.
Yeah, so my thing is, since we do have the option in Streamlabs to stream on multiple things, I was actually thinking about going ahead and streaming to YouTube, because seeing that he gets 500k, even if that's a big name, 500k, that means that people will start to stop by YouTube and, you know, pick up that. So I wouldn't mind picking up that extra content, or pushing that extra content to YouTube, and then pushing my name out there. Maybe we can get more viewers on our videos and everything and stuff like that. So I wouldn't mind doing the double stream to YouTube.
So why do people say that?
Test the waters. That's
go
it.
For it. See
so,
if it works.
Pay for money. Pay for money.
Why do people say that? Once you start, like, if you already have a channel going on YouTube, if you start streaming, it kills your channel. Why do people have that type of
people say that
on YouTube? What? I've heard it a few times.
I've never heard this. So.
Never heard that either.
Yeah, I heard. Our boy said it in our Pond Gaming DM or whatever. I'm not gonna throw his name out there.
So it's better to just upload clips like we have just regular YouTube videos.
I mean, I don't know. That's why I'm asking, because, I mean, all I'm doing right now is posting, like, clips or, like, highlights
on YouTube. I've heard the opposite, to be honest.
Really?
It grows more if you're streaming and uploading videos on your YouTube channel.
I mean, to me, it makes sense, because people already go to YouTube to watch videos, so why not go to YouTube to watch, like,
they need to work on their algorithms and their UI.
I think it's their UI more than anything. It's the UI, bro. It's the UI. Yeah.
I opened up Destiny just curious to see how many people are watching streaming. I couldn't tell how many people were streaming, but there was the first streamer I saw on Destiny was a person that had 5 viewers. And
nice.
And then you go and you see Garena Free Fire, which is a mobile game, and it has a 200k viewers. I'm like, what's going on here in YouTube for the gaming? It doesn't feel like, it feels like it's only good for established big time streamers. Because it's impossible for me to find.
You can't small find streamers. New. You can't, I can't find good small streamers. Small streamers.
I tried.
Yeah.
I can't find.
Ah, yeah. Okay.
That's my
thing. So you think it's not like starter friendly?
I
don't. What you're saying.
I mean, you can definitely get a better outreach, but I really did try to find starter streamers, and I could not.
Well, we'll see what the streaming wars brings to the table, because now we got FB Gaming trying to be a powerhouse. Twitch, of course, is a powerhouse. You ain't got to worry about Mixer anymore, and then YouTube is trying to do whatever. I mean, I'm just being honest, bro. Mixer kind of fucked all of us over, so.
Ain't got to worry about them. Dusty yeah. must be like,
Dusty
there's
must that.
In the dirt. Left him in the dirt. Don't fucking matter.
It's a good thing that we freaking had a backup, right, Al?
Bro, like, I honestly
it's
feel
good thing
like.
It's restreaming.
Yeah. Well, not just that, but I feel like if we weren't already networking ahead of, like, in Mixer, switching to Twitch would have been a huge pain in the ass.
Of course, yes.
Huge pain in the ass.
We already had at least a couple of a small community. We already had, like, a Discord with, like, 60-plus people
yes.
at the time.
Exactly. So, I mean, shout out to everybody that moved from Mixer to Twitch or wherever you went after Mixer, man, because I'm pretty sure everybody's in the same grinding and building rebuild mode still. I mean, it officially shut down, what, July 22nd?
So it has, or something like that, yeah.
Yeah, so it hasn't even been a month, and some people probably stuck around to stream on Mixer until it actually went away and shit like that. So shout out to everybody that's a Mixer refugee.
Yeah, people were still
live on it. People didn't know. Some people didn't know until shutdown day.
So I did want to talk about a few games, actually two games. So Ace reminded me that the beta for Avengers came out.
Let's go, Avengers.
I'm a little salty. I'm a little salty, not going to lie.
You want to talk about that?
Why are you salty?
I'm salty because, hello, exclusive characters, bro. Are we still doing that?
I'm more salty by the beta situation they just did to us. Why is
what?
Sony in charge of this?
That's what I want. That too.
So I know
that part.
So I know this is fucked up, but it comes down to Sony having some rights over Marvel. So
Spider-Man, Sony, that's it.
I mean, not just Spider-Man. I think they actually have a portion of Marvel stock as well and a part of their company. I think some of them, Sony members are on the board or something like that.
I'm gonna have to research that.
Don't take my word for that.
I'm gonna have to research that.
But I know there's a deal between them because it's always been. I think that happened with Marvel's Avengers back in the day when you know the OG Marvel's Avengers where
like Ultimate Alliance.
Ultimate Alliance. Here we go.
Yeah. Okay.
I think they had characters on Ultimate Alliance as well on PlayStation 2 that they didn't have on Xbox. And so
I don't think console exclusive was a thing. During 360
hey,
and PlayStation 3.
What's up?
I do not remember.
I vaguely remember, but the contract was in charge of, you know, everything cinematically for Spider-Man. That was that. Mm-hmm. But it was also, and I remember this exactly, it was one dedicated game for Spider-Man.
Which
that,
is
that
most...
That came.
It's already came.
That's
it already came.
Spider-Man. That's
yeah, exactly.
The whole exclusive Spider-Man part, I was like...
But, so okay, why is Spider-Man exclusive?
Case, what if... Let's just think about this. What if... The reason they did that was because they're trying to push more content to only Sony and make all Marvel games a Sony exclusive. What if they did that?
Did Sony put in some money to get that?
Thank you.
I mean, you never know, but it could be a future thing because wasn't Spider-Man a Sony exclusive?
Yeah. Nah,
yes,
bro.
They,
not
that was on
the original Spider-Man?
Yeah, like But how did Spider-Man start? Like, it was a game.
No, no, not the original Spider-Man. The Spider-Man that came out 2 years ago or a year ago.
The one that was on contract.
Like, the video game. The video game. Yeah. The new Spider-Man game is an exclusive, but it's made by Insomniac or whatever, which is a Sony-owned developer house. So that makes sense.
Yeah.
That makes sense. But the fact that you're making a whole character exclusive to Sony.
Oh, now that you said that, Pride, yep, that makes sense. Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy's makers are making this game, aren't they?
Square Enix.
Crystal. Yes. What's their name?
Square Enix. Yeah.
Kingdom of Hearts, Final Fantasy, all that. Square Enix and PlayStation are, you know, buddy.
They're cool. They're in cahoots, yeah, bro.
So they have My Worst Enemy says they have another Miles Morales game will be exclusive too. Is that not just a DLC update to the Spider-Man?
Oh, wait. I thought that was a whole new, like, they're making.
It's DLC, right? Okay. It's DLC.
But it's supposed to be as big as the game, right?
Yeah, it's supposed to be basically a whole new game, but specifically for Miles Morales. I saw that.
Okay.
It's standalone? You know, it's confirmed.
There we go. I thought it was, really? I thought it was standalone.
Hey, posted said it was edition.
My Worst Enemy. If you can find an article, post it in the Discord so I can read it.
You sure they didn't mean like it was edition, like it was just part two of the game? Because you know Miles Morales was in Spider-Man, the game. His whole.
My Worst Enemy. Post that in Discord for me so I can read it later.
A redacted podcast channel.
Yeah.
The main reason I want to talk about the game is because I think the beta could have been more, because it still leaves me with that question in the air, like, is this enough content to push us until the new characters come out and until the new content comes out?
Have you played the hard missions as well? Because I've only witnessed people run through the story missions, and then they've been replaying a lot of the harder, like, almost like they're almost like strikes, I guess. That's
the strike mission. Yeah. That's all I've seen so far is the story and then the strikes.
Yeah.
And it's not the full story, and it's not all the strikes, of course. But
of course.
I'm just worried that they only give us, like, let's just say what Destiny did and gives us, like, what, maybe three strikes from the jump?
They only gave us, like, two, I think. Two strikes. Yeah, two strikes. Mm-hmm. So you played it then, right? Like the beta? Like you've played it yet?
No, I've been watching the streams. Okay.
Well, I will say, because I bought the deluxe, and it doesn't come with anything special as far as, like, it gives you access to the beta, like, 3 days ahead of time. So I think I actually might be able to play it.
Well,
I'll have to check it.
Not this weekend.
So this is in regards to Avengers. Okay, so, yes. Can we change topic? You guys have been playing Rogue Company a lot. Speaking of games you can't play yet. Game you're playing right now, Rogue Company.
It's been fun. So I know that a lot of people are like, this isn't my type of game,
That's my type.
Yeah, I respect that. You know, everybody has a type of game. You know, I won't play no League of Legends because that's not my type of game.
Mm-hmm. I can admit too.
But Rogue Company, I know it doesn't look graphically pleasing, and it does.
A lot of people complain about the third person.
I say the people are graphically pleasing, but the backgrounds and everything, they could use a lot more detail work to me. I'm one of those people that look at the backgrounds and I'm like, I can tell that you are still missing something right there.
Yeah.
Like
better rendering, maybe, or some shit.
Better
like
rendering,
that.
Exactly. Wait a sec. I know that Pride said that he doesn't like that you can just pull, like, people are basically corner watching and scoping right there, waiting for you to round the corner and shit like that. And that shit can get annoying. But I've also noticed it's easy for those people that are corner watching to also get flanked, because they're so focused on looking at that corner that they don't think about, oh, there's three other people on the team that could probably be left, right, and behind me. So I think there, even though there's aspects of the game that are kind of shitty, there are aspects of the game that make up for those shitty components and push those shitty components out the window for me personally. I love the game. I definitely play it any other day. It's Apex and Rogue Company for me right now.
My problem with the game. First of all, I'm gonna highlight the good things. I like the style of the game. I like the characters, the weapon, the buy system. Mm-hmm. Trust me, a lot of the game, part of the game, I'm like, you're doing this right. You're doing this right. They already have a roadmap for rank. They have a for custom games. They are doing everything right. But since the third, and I know you say it's not like, I personally feel like the third person stuff is like one of the most core thing of the game. Same thing I said about Fortnite, because Fortnite's marketing was great, but the core thing about Fortnite was building. And personally for me, my play style and shooters, it doesn't line up with that. And so that's why I don't like the game.
So what's your play style, Prod?
I like flanking and being able to like use sight lines and stuff like that is what I usually do. So I kept dying a lot in that game because I would
ace.
Your mix it up screen is
Anywho,
oh my god!
When I was playing that game a lot, I would try to like push, you know, kind of like how Ace does, but I would always die.
Misspelled my name, not in the command. Misspelled.
Wait, did I?
Not the command.
I'm missing A. Damn.
Awkward.
Damn.
You strike out like three times today. But so
bro, I'm on a 10 game. I'm on a 10 day contract right now, bro. Like they about to kick me off the team at this point. They about to kick me. My bags are packed, fam. They about
we over here looking like, man, worst enemy looking pretty good for a new
me.
Let's put Dangles. We'll find a fourth. We need a new fourth.
God damn, bro. I'm about to get subbed out.
Auditions this Saturday, guys.
God damn, man. That shit hilarious.
The game's cool. It just doesn't fit my style of FPS, personally.
Same. I don't like the idea of third-person FPS. I feel like I'm not good.
I just can't get. I can't get with it.
I like it.
I've never been good at that perspective of game. Like Fortnite, GTA, anything that involves shooting from that perspective, Gears of War, any of that. I'm not very good.
Dude, I fuck with Gears of War.
That's the reason that I hate. That's one of the reasons I hate Gears of War. Like I do not like third person shooting. Right. But for some
Gears is a nice ass game. Y'all sleep.
But for some reason, this shit just runs.
Okay, maybe
with
Rogue Bangs. Maybe Rogue Bangs. Okay.
Rogue Company fire too.
But you also like Black Death. No, I'm just kidding. I mean.
Stop. True.
I will defend Black Death to the day.
I like the fact that it's so different compared to other games that I played, but it kind of like lets me step into that Valorant-esque realm without playing Valorant, because I know Valorant is not my type of game, but it gives me that type of setup or whatever as far as like competitive, that type of thing. The only thing I don't like, though, is I don't like the community. I don't like the Rogue Company community right now.
I've never experienced them. How bad is it?
It's extremely toxic. I've listened to, like, I haven't experienced anything, but, like, I've watched, like, Val streams and shit, and people be, like, going off, like, just so toxic, bro, like, for whatever reason. It's just annoying. Not if you're playing Demolition.
I would also like to point out that a lot of people that play the games don't realize that they have to play as a team. Mm-hmm. And when you see your teammate right below you needing the res, and you're sitting there trying to corner watch and wait for a scope, you got time to fucking res that person.
But they don't res. They don't res in that game.
And be like, well, you're dead, so it's your fault. Like, who does that, bro?
They do
not
res in
that
game.
Do you not want to win the goddamn game? You see those lives points up right there? Them points that says, oh, now you're down to four lives. Now you're down to three lives. You realize that doesn't go down if you res somebody, right?
Like, yeah.
Think about it, bro.
I'm not gonna lie to you. That's one reason why I would like a game. The game, if the community's toxic.
Wow.
Because I feel it's like Call of Duty over again.
That's terrible. That's terrible. That is terrible.
That's one of my highlights for a game. Let's get.
Let him know, little
like,
Timmy.
I'm about to start playing Rogue Company again. And I'm gonna start having a little Timmy saying certain words and like, I'm dating you all over again. Let's go.
Like, damn, Timmy, you really let me know, bro.
Y'all are some terrible ass people, bro.
I never
oh my
that.
God.
Y'all are some terrible ass people. Oh my god.
What else am I, Timmy? Give it to me. You want me to suck your what? Oh no, Timmy.
MWT was so good. I'm like, what did that man just say to me?
One of my favorite games that kind of turned to shit is this game called Foxhole, where it's 60v60 RTS. Each unit is controlled by a player, and you can't outrank people. Oh, damn.
That sounds like fucking wild. If I could get toxic.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. Is that like Halo Wars type shit? Or you can outrank people?
You don't like real-time strategy games?
Man, Halo. Okay, so let me tell you something. I think this is the only reason I hated Halo Wars. I was young when it came out. And so came out, I bought
that
game.
I'm like, what the
fuck is this? It was $60. I bought that game. I was like, yes, another Halo. I put that shit in, and it was like, oh, you gotta play from the sky. Wait, I'm gonna tell these people where to go. Like, wait, what? Where's Chief?
Oh, that's why. Why am I not Master Chief? You didn't realize it was an RTS. Oh, no.
Exactly. I was
RTS game.
Yeah.
I looked at my dad and was like, Dad.
Take it back.
Take it back, please.
That's crazy. But as
go ahead.
I was going to say to close back on or to close the Avengers talk. I was going to say I'm very optimistic for it if they continue to push content. But content's supposed to be free for that game, so we're gonna see. We're gonna
see. They're gonna do they're gonna do MTX. That's what that means.
Yeah, microtransactions. Free, but it's cosmetic only though, which I'm fine with. I'm totally fine with that because if you actually look at some of the skins they got, from old school skins for all the characters to like some just like comic book skins from like actual like legitimate comic books that me and several other people around the world have probably read, to new shit. I mean, it looks dope. Hopefully they can supply
that's
it with good enough content.
In gaming
so.
World, free.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind dropping some stacks on skins.
I'm gonna do this real quick. Boy, get her.
Nice.
Get that out of here.
For today's battle class, y'all. Cool, it was something we might have put a primer on last night. But the new live action Mulan movie is hitting Disney Plus streaming services. Soon.
Bo's ready for this.
How much is $25.99? $30. $30.
$30 of them things.
$30 of them things.
Hey, appreciate that, Bo. Appreciate that, Bo.
I'm a winner.
Should movies on streaming services be free if you already paying for the streaming service?
Yes.
Yes.
Hold on, they're dancing.
Hold on.
Beautiful morning.
I'm gonna see if I can be the first input on this situation. So I'm
always
ready. Hey, I feel it. Appreciate that, Bo. Appreciate that, man. Appreciate the stuff.
Okay. Ready for this? All right. Okay. Yep. So here's the deal I have with Disney's little grimy little bullshit they pulled off. Every other movie that has come out since COVID that's been just straight buy because theaters aren't a thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's been on like, I don't know, pay-per-view or, you know, anything, YouTube, you know, anything. Sites that you don't pay monthly for. And you pay 20, maybe at max, $25. You get the movie forever on YouTube. You don't subscribe to YouTube, do you? You don't subscribe to pay-per-view. I haven't been on pay-per-view, but these like Amazon has it to where you can watch movies without being on Amazon Prime. You don't subscribe to Amazon to buy that movie, right?
Correct.
So why would Disney do it to where first you have to subscribe to their service? And then you have to pay not max $25 like every other movie's been, $30 to have the movie. So let's say down the line, you don't want to have Disney Plus no more. You bought about 4 or 5, maybe 6 movies. I don't know why, but you did. Now you lost the movies because you don't have the service.
Exactly. Huh? And that point is very valid, but my issue is the fact that, bro, their other shows, like their top tier shows, did not require an extra fee besides what you're already paying monthly for. Like,
it's a show.
Hold on. Mandalorian has big screen production behind it.
Yeah.
Right?
Still a TV show.
That's Lucas, though.
And I understand that. But it's still a subsidiary of Disney. Am I right or wrong in that?
But I'm just saying, like, if that TV show was going to be in a movie theater, then I'd see it the same way.
But
go ahead, Ace.
That's fine, though, right? But my issue is that I'm already paying for the subscription to watch Disney Plus every month, right? Why couldn't some type of deal or whatever they do in finance and accounting and all that other bullshit, why couldn't something be worked out to where I mean, okay, I'd be cool with a $5 additional charge, right? Because maybe they've put a way more production in this Mulan movie, and that'd be great, right, for the viewer. But if it's on the same level as Mandalorian, it's confusing me because I'm trying to justify the $30 expense.
Okay, yes, I will not, just to play devil's advocate here. And it's a point I didn't realize until halfway through this podcast, but I have to consider the pre-COVID movie release experience versus post-COVID movie release.
Why didn't no other movie company do it?
Mm-hmm. Well, okay. Well, I'm not mad at somebody for being the Apple or the first, I guess, but at doing something to change the game. But make it make sense. Make it justifiable. Make it justifiable because to me, right, I'm not spending $30 solely on, well, yeah, I'm spending $30 solely on movie tickets, right? But that's a one-time thing, right?
Okay, so, you ready?
Well, hold on. I got one more point and then I'm going to let you out of flow. I'm going to let you out of flow. But in that two movie ticket, one-time thing experience, right, I'm going to like Warren Theater, where the screen is like 4K and I'm getting like Dolby Atmos experience with the recliner and shit, right?
Warren
like
Warren is a $50 experience by itself.
I've never spent $50 solely on movie tickets at Warren Theater.
So the fact that it's not 50 and it's 30, shouldn't it be like 15 from Disney?
Thank you.
You take your whole family, you spend way more than $20.
All right, you ready? You ready? Yeah.
Let's see. All right, King.
It's yours. All
right, let's get ready to rumble. So We're gonna take it from let's see, Prize perspective. Prize perspective was that once you drop the subscription, you can no longer get the video. I completely respect that. That is something that I didn't even think about. If they have it to where you can actually not get it even when you bought it, then that's something they need to work out within tweaks, and I'm pretty sure that is something that they will work out, because I know Disney is one of the companies that are money hungry, grimy, so I know that, because they've opened Disney around the world before it should have been open. I mean, people are going to Disney till this day.
Crazy.
So I know they're money hungry, so I think that's something that either they're bored, or somebody's got to talk to them about that, because that's something that does need to get fixed. Because if I spend $30 on this movie, then that is my movie. That's my movie, no matter
what. Should be.
Going to Aces. So the whole thing is, yes, this is $30 on top of the subscription, but like I said yesterday, this is $30 going toward their movie production. And I get, you know, Mandalorian had movie production content. But that is also Lucasfilm. Their funds are coming mainly from Lucas. Lucas has a surplus of money. And not only that, he wants you to visually see his art in that shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he doesn't care what the cost is going to be. He's going to drop that penny for that shit. When it comes down to Disney, I think Mulan, because Mulan is the first one, I think they probably did drop $30 worth of fucking shit right there. And when it comes down to just spending $30, you have a household. The typical household is 2.5 to 3 people in that household. You're typically paying for 3 people to watch that movie when you spend that $30 right there.
Okay, but imagine the movie being trash, because we all know how we feel about live action.
Yes.
Okay, but imagine going to the movie theater, buying that popcorn and everything, and you spend that $50.
At least I got the popcorn.
But you got popcorn at home. That point can't go there, because you can still go to the movie theater and watch a movie that's trash.
Right now.
Very true.
Like that thing doesn't. Yeah. You can't really stand on that ground, because no matter what. But going back to it, you're paying $30, and of course, the people that have Disney subscriptions still after COVID are probably going to still keep it after Mulan, and they're going to keep on pushing that movie or watching that movie. They're going to keep on letting other people see the movie. You know, your auntie going to call up like, "Hey, you got Disney Plus?" And you're like, "Yeah." She's like, "You got that Mulan though." Be like, "Yeah, auntie, I got that Mulan here," and you slide it that shit right there. that's, you're just letting another person watch that movie that they won't get that 30 for. So, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm for profit. And I know that hurts because it's like, you know, we are in a pandemic and shit sucks, but I'm for profit. Like, I'm that's just the business side of me, that I'm not going to let my company flop and I'm not going to let my employees fail because we're in a pandemic. Everybody needs to eat. Just like you guys need to eat. You guys need money in this pandemic. The person who plays Mulan, the person who plays her sub-actors, whoever they have in the actor, whoever made the video production, they need to
eat. They already got paid,
too.
Though.
Okay.
They got paid for whatever they got paid on that.
They get paid before cinematic releases.
Exactly. And then that money that comes after, that's their career. This is their career, Al. Imagine you doing...
The residual. The residual. Imagine
you doing coding and you only got paid half of what you were going to get paid. Imagine you getting paid $400 when you should have got $1.5K. How pissed would you be?
Okay, but the bigger question that I have is, this going to be the new release model for movies post-COVID life, right? And if so,
there's two
I don't
things.
Like every movie doing this.
Okay.
To say about that majority of actors and actresses and stuff, they get paid before releases. That is their paycheck. What the movie makes itself goes to the corporation, not to the actors' actions. So they wouldn't have got anything anyways.
I wouldn't imagine that being every actor's.
So it's the budget
then.
I'm
pretty sure, because let's say Johnny Depp, bro. Johnny Depp couldn't have possibly made that much money before the movie, and then
they get paid a lot.
Why not? You're actively working. You're clocking in. You're putting in hours.
Names get paid a lot, but let's just say you're somebody small. Like, who knows who the Mulan girl is? Who knows who she is?
She's already got a check.
She could also. You said what?
She already got her check.
She did.
But how much is it?
Actually, trust me, I know this because my dad's in plays. My brother does movies. I know this from T. Like, this is literally like what my brother and my dad do.
Okay.
Actors and actresses and everything get paid pre-release, and then that's
okay. So then with what Prod just said, so then the actor's salary or whatever they get for doing that movie is included in the initial budget before anything is any film, any shit is shot, right?
Exactly.
Okay, so then that still raises my question: why in the fuck is Mulan $30?
There's still the point of this, though. Like, let's just say they went. Their budget, right? They paid all their actors, and let's say whatever left is to cover the production. It's their profit, right? Let's just say that, okay?
But not even a DVD is $30, and you own the DVD for life.
How much is? I mean, I think DVDs nowadays go about $25, right?
Blu-ray, or just buying it digitally.
There is a marketing standpoint for watching on release and watching 6 months later. That's people.
Yeah,
okay, so you're talking about depreciation type shit. Okay, that makes sense.
Essentially, they would still be losing money if they made this big ass production and then only charged $15. I know it sucks to pay $30 for one movie, and this possibly being the future movie release standpoint, but people still need their money back. People still need profit. People still need.
And I something. Get that. I get where you're coming from. I understand that at the end of the day, it's a business. They run a business, right? They're producing a movie. They've put in however much millions of dollars to actually produce the movie. They need to see some type of profit. I understand the business side of things. My only thing is, not only are companies in a COVID pandemic where, you know, like, you actually have to do certain shit to make sure that your company don't go under, but so are everyday people. I wouldn't be tripping on this, on what they're trying to do, if it just wasn't $30. I could understand if it was $10 or $15.
Yeah, 15 or 20. Yeah,
like, but 30, bro,
you got to be at some point, you got to make it to where you're somewhat consumer friendly, or it's consumers leave. Like, they just like, no.
So okay. So let's just
okay, but then that also begs the question: can Amazon do this?
No, Amazon doesn't. Who the fuck watches Amazon? What?
Hold on. Amazon Prime has a pretty deep subscription service, bro.
You don't have to be Amazon Primed to get movies. You can.
Yeah, if
you
they straight.
You just buy movies. There's no big part of subscription to get Amazon movies, and that's what Disney should be doing too. Because look at Amazon. Amazon's making money more and more every day.
So wait. You think Disney should just cancel their subscription then?
No, they no. Make it to where if you want Mulan, you don't need to be subscribed to Disney. That's literally all they have to do. And it makes
so then,
sense.
So then what if they said you don't have to be subscribed to Disney, but it's still going to be $30?
Okay.
Then I'm fine with that. Get your money.
That makes perfect sense.
Get your money.
You don't have to make a subscription because no other person that has it, Amazon doesn't do it. Netflix can't do it because they don't have movies like that. But no other movie that comes out has it to where if they're, you know, hey, you need to be subscribed to this, you know, this or that, then you can buy my movie.
But I think this goes. I think this also plays into a bigger question of if you really think about it, bro. Streaming, like the industry of streaming, whether it's music, movies, video, shit like that. How much a stream is worth is very ambiguous. Nobody knows how much an actual stream is worth. So, like, one playthrough of Mulan, how much is that worth? That's not worth all 30 of my dollars, right? It's like one stream of a song is not worth, like, the whole cost of an entire album, right? It's probably, like, fractions of a penny.
Wait. But you are essentially still paying that $30 if you go to the movie theater. You're still getting that one view.
$30 for one movie, bro. Like, we're talking about...
watching.
I don't think
for a limited amount of times.
Unlimited, that's fine if you don't. Again, it's fine if you don't have to have the subscription service. But
yeah,
what I was getting at is like people don't know how to calculate how much a stream is worth. Meaning, is one stream of Mulan, say like I watch Mulan one time, one time, never watch it again, right?
Why would you do that to yourself?
Right.
But I'm pretty sure. But I'm exactly. Some people just don't
so
watch
it's not
movies
worth
like
you
that.
Having forever.
So
you
what's the point?
If you're a solo person, I understand where you're coming
but
from.
But still, let's say okay, I've only watched G.I. Joe one time, and I spent that $20 to go see the movie. And I've
only
watched it one time.
I don't know why you spent $20 for one ticket to go see G.I. Joe. Well, you could have just waited for it to be on Netflix like your boy did.
Why would you wait?
You could have just waited. You can wait. From that point, you can just wait these next 3 weeks or 3 months or a year, however long it takes for them to put it on Blu-ray and whoop-de-whoop and Disney Plus subscription.
But that defeats the purpose of streaming services, though. The point of streaming services is to have shit on demand right then and there. You ain't got to wait, right?
Marvel Avengers, the last one wasn't on demand.
No, it wasn't. That was pre-COVID. That was pre-COVID, though.
DuckTales 3 still ain't on.
What I'm saying is the release of a movie. Like, so you just used Avengers. That was released pre-COVID. So, of course, you built the hype up, the marketing. You didn't spend all this fucking money on just getting it out there and all that, on marketing materials and stuff like that. So I can understand the movie ticket price. But, fam, we ain't even seen a trailer of Mulan. Where's the marketing?
I'm gonna keep it $1.50 with you. I can't imagine them spending a dime on somebody's TV channel saying, "Hey, come see Marvel's right now." Because yeah. I could imagine every TV channel be like, "Hey, you want that Marvel commercial on my channel? Hey, put it on there.
What are you talking about? They still had to spend money to market the movie, right? We have not seen the latest thing we've seen on Mulan is this piece of news we're talking about right now.
I've seen the trailer.
I've seen the trailer.
Send me a most recent trailer? Like, you've seen them pubbing Mulan trailers like they be pubbing, or like they were pubbing movies before COVID.
Because Mulan's not, essentially, Mulan's not Avengers. Avengers has six guys.
That's not my point. You're missing my point. My point is that they're not spending as much money on marketing materials like they would pre-COVID, which in my head would justify... the movie ticket price or the $30. They're not.
Why do you wait?
No, it's my turn. Maybe they have redirected a lot of their funds to digital AdSense, but they're not spending money on posters in the movie theater. They're not spending money on special wrap Mulan popcorn bowls and popcorn cups or soda cups and whatever, like the swag that you get at the movie theater that is like special release Mulan, like those fixtures they set up, that all costs money. They're not doing that.
So that's what I'm saying. How are they justifying the $30 of just one movie? Because I'm not seeing the type of work that to me I would need to see be put in on a movie like this if you're going to charge me $30.
I'm just confused at why you're lost here. You're paying for a movie to keep forever.
That's That's not what I'm tripping on. I understand that. It's the fact that it's on a stream. It's going to be released on a streaming service day one. People ain't gotta worry about going to a movie theater because obviously we're in COVID time, so we're in a post COVID society right now. So I get that aspect. My question is, my original question was, is this going to be the model in which streaming services are going to release original content or original movies in? Because
let me talk to you, Doc. Mulan's budget was $200 million. $200 million. So if you expect me, as a chairman, to look at that paycheck, that $200 million, $10 million goes to each actor, $100 million goes to the video production, and let's just say I got $50 million left over. You think that I'm not about to push as much as I possibly can for who's left on my platform for that? Hell nah, bro.
To be honest, if he was smart, they would still keep that $30, and they would nuke the subscription mainly because you're gonna have a better net gain.
You would reach more people.
A better net gain if you didn't subscribe to Disney. I've been saying the $30 is fine. You're buying the movie. It's yours. Mm-hmm. Just get rid of the subscription thing. You're gonna reach a lot.
And I wouldn't trip on that. This wouldn't even be a conversation because now I understand, like, oh damn, look, you ain't charging, you're not requiring people to have a subscription service to access this movie. So yeah, charge $30. But it's the fact that you have to have a subscription service. Like you have to have a subscription to Disney service.
Anyone, you don't have to subscribe. I don't. Why would
you only reaching this 10% that's still on Disney right now, dog? Come on, man.
And you know people canceled their subscription after Mandalorian season one was over with. You know people did that.
You know everyone canceled Disney after that.
Honestly, I kind of don't. I get it because you know Mandalorian was the staple. That was the holy ground right there.
Yeah, because that was a strongly pushed original content series of the drop of Disney Plus.
I mean, the Star Wars extended cuts are on there. I mean, the Disney movies are on there in the new HD and everything. I'm loving that content.
The problem I have with this all is I'm glad Mandalorian came out and that's new content for Disney Plus. But the main reason why I canceled mine was I looked over at my DVD set and I saw everything in that streaming service and all my, and it's not everybody, it's not everybody has this. But I literally saw almost everything in DVD right next to my TV and I was like, well, why not?
Well, thank God I actually get Disney Plus for free. Otherwise, I would have canceled it too.
I mean, I would have canceled it too. That's true, but granted, I have all those movies too. But the thing is, I don't. You probably have them on DVD. I have them on VHS. And
yep, throwback.
I like the new visuals of it. This shit is dope to me. And ask me how many times I don't watch Hercules, bro. I can recite that shit word for word, bro.
No, I'm just kidding. I love Hercules.
Bro, I have all the original Disney collection on VHS up in my mom's attic right now, bro. Like, that is childhood memories.
I would just say these are all good points. We are reaching an hour of the podcast. I think we did a pretty good job at stating a pretty good case for both sides. But at the end of the day, you're either gonna pay $30 or you're not gonna see Mulan.
Yeah, that's obviously that's the way they're doing it.
$45, to be honest, so
either you're paying or you're not, and you're not.
So you're not watching Mulan, damn it. So I don't know.
The only way I wouldn't be watching Mulan is if it was above 30. I think 30 is the max that I would pay personally.
Last point I want to make on this Mulan topic. But Disney could be doing this in an attempt to revive their Disney Plus numbers, subscription numbers.
Yep.
Would that revive it? Shit.
Because you're forcing people.
They're driving them to the app.
Yeah, you're forcing people to have a subscription to the Disney Plus service just to watch one movie. But you also have to pay $30 for the movie. But so,
not,
I mean,
not
hey.
If you make a new email and you put that free 2 weeks on there. Or
that, too,
week,
that too. That too. But anywho.
I'm just gonna watch it on Media.
All the points made, y'all. I mean, I think it goes without saying that we could probably argue about this all night.
Also, probably it is out in Germany right now, so you could watch it with German subtitles.
Open up my Media channel real quick.
Slack me, Doc.
$3.99.
No, all right, people, man.
Yeah, let me get this free.
It's been nice talking to y'all, man. Shout out to all y'all for coming through. Shout out to the viewers.
Shout out to the Gray Box, y'all. How y'all doing? I'm Gray Box.
Yeah, love y'all, man.
Gray Box Prod.
If y'all if y'all have any recommendations on what y'all want us to talk about in 2 weeks, or how we can make it better for y'all in enjoyment, just talk to us. You know, hit us up in the Discord. Can I get exclamation Discord, exclamation Pine?
Yep.
And hit us up in the Discord. Tell us, like, hey, you know what? You should do this or you should do that. Talk to us about this. Like, I bet this is a good topic. You know? let that shit ride. You know, we always down to talk to the people. We are some down-ass motherfuckers, man.
I'm pretty up,
man. I know you can't see Pride, but he looks like a hippie, man. So, you know.
Perfect.
He looks like Psycho Witch from Victorious. Right, only the black version.
All right. That being said, I think I'm done. Thank you guys for tuning in. We'll see you
appreciate
back
y'all. Appreciate
for the
y'all. Appreciate
podcast
y'all.
Episode 4.
Love y'all, man.
Oh, next week, y'all might see a little outro, intro, music, and everything. We might make up our own mixtapes, all that.
We leveling up.
Shit, nah.
Peace.
Bye.
Peace.